For this screencast, we're going to discuss material selection. Specifically, we're going to discuss how we'll use elastic properties of materials to choose candidates for our design problem. If we take a look at our problem statement, we have a cylindrical rod that's 380 millimeters long. It's going to have a diameter of 10 millimeters. We anticipate that it's going to be subjected to a tensile load. The rod is not to experience plastic deformation, and it's not to have an elongation more than 0.9 millimeters, and the applied load is going to be 24,500 newtons. We have four metals or alloys that are listed, and we need to take a look at which of these is going to be a candidate. So to go ahead and start, let's mark down our known values. We know force is equal to 24,500 newtons. The diameter of the rod is going to be 10 millimeters, making our radius 5 millimeters. We know the initial length is going to be 380 millimeters. And we know that our elongation delta L can be no more than 0.9 millimeters. The equations that we will need for this problem include engineering stress, where sigma equals F over A naught. Here, F is going to be our applied force, and A naught is going to be our cross-sectional area. We'll also be using engineering strain, where epsilon equals delta L over L naught. Here, delta L is our change in length, or our elongation, and L naught is going to be our original length of the rod. Lastly, we're going to be using Hooke's law, which allows us to relate our modulus of elasticity, also known as stiffness, which is E, to the engineering stress and strain. The first step to solving this problem is to determine the applied stress that the rod is going to end up seeing with our applied load. We can do this using our engineering stress equation, so sigma equaling F over A naught. Our force was given as 24,500 newtons. And our radius was given as 5 millimeters. Now keep in mind, we want to make sure that our final units are in newton meters or in megapascals, so we need to go ahead and convert our 5 millimeters into meters. So our final answer is 3.11 times 10 to the 8th newton meters, which is equal to 311 megapascals. Just as a reminder, 1 megapascal is equal to 1 times 10 to the 6th newton meter squared. So our 311 megapascals is the applied stress that we're going to end up seeing on this rod. What this means is that we need to have a material that can withstand the applied stress without plastic deformation taking place. So if we look back up at our table that includes all of the material properties and specifically take a look at the column with yield stress, we'll notice that there's actually only two materials that have yield stresses that are going to be greater than the applied stress. One is the brass alloy at 345 megapascals, and the other one is the steel alloy at 450 megapascals. So at this point, we can go ahead and eliminate aluminum as well as copper as potential materials for this problem. So the next step we need to go ahead and do is check brass and steel for the elongation requirement. Using Hooke's law and engineering strain, we can go ahead and find the maximum elongation for both brass and steel. So using Hooke's law, where sigma is equal to E times epsilon, we can solve for epsilon, and we also know that epsilon is equal to delta L over L naught. As a reminder, delta L over L naught comes directly from the engineering strain equation. We can now solve for delta L, and this now gives us an equation to be able to determine what the maximum elongation is for each material. So we can now evaluate both brass and steel. So we can go ahead and solve for delta L for brass, where we'll have 311 megapascals over 100,000 megapascals times 380 millimeters. One thing to note is if we go back up and take a look at our table, our values for Young's modulus are given in gigapascals. So hence, to be able to convert that to megapascals, that is why we have 100,000 megapascals for this problem. So if we go ahead and calculate this, we find that our final answer is going to be 1.18 millimeters for brass. And now we need to go ahead and calculate the elongation for steel. So going through the same process, we'll move down and go ahead and calculate delta L for steel. Using the properties of steel, we have 311 megapascals over 207,000 megapascals. So that is Young's modulus for steel times our 380 millimeters. So the final elongation for steel would be 0.57 millimeters. What these values represent is the elongation we can expect if we end up using brass or we end up using steel. So in this case, we know that delta L max can only be 0.9 millimeters. So brass is going to elongate 1.18 millimeters, while steel is only going to elongate 0.57 millimeters. So for this problem, steel is the only material that will end up working. And if we go back and double check, our steel is going to satisfy both our elongation requirement as well as our requirement that we ended up needing for stress.